Warning, this content may be upsetting or disturbing to some audiences. Based on my experience, there are way more pedophiles than you could imagine. I am a pedophile who has been arrested, ask me anything. I am a pedophile. I would like to do and ask me anything regarding my mental illness. That being said, I have never harmed a child. The reason that I would like to do this is to present a view of this condition from the position of someone suffering from it and not from what people are in news headlines. It is hell and there is no support and no one to reach out to. I'm certain that many users on this site suffer similarly and others who have suffered at the hands of people with this condition, and I would like the opportunity for people to discuss this with a sufferer.
Question. What age group are you most affected by? I had a friend that was found with thousands of images on his computer of child pornography. It was awful, and no one would have ever expected it from him. The worst was how well he was seen by the community for his interactions with children and how involved he was with kids' sporting groups and such. He has never acted on his urges, or so he says, and no one has come forward. Anywho, what struck me the hardest was that his images were of infants and toddlers. How can someone find it in their will to see a child in this way?
Yeah, I've seen those kind of images. They make me sick too. Personally, I am more impacted by females from around 11 plus. I think the thing that draws me towards them is the innocence and purity that I can see. It is not purely a sexual attraction, but there is an element of that.
Did you act on your urges? Were you able to contain yourself somehow? Why have you been arrested? How did you become one? Did you thought about turning yourself in because you didn't want to hurt anyone?
Basically, I was arrested for a single image that traced my IP address. I did not create that image and was not distributing it. I discovered in my teen years, I initially justified it as I was into people my own age and then realized that it was not normal as I got older. I didn't turn myself in and wouldn't have done as it would mean I would lose my job, and being an out pedophile is essentially volunteering for social exclusion. I also am certain that I would never act out against a child.
Interesting. Another question, if I may. There is a medical case of a man with a tumor in his brain that caused pedophilia. This happened twice to this man, but it is very rare. The question is, would you rather stay you, or become what we see as normal?
Yeah, I heard about that. Frontal lobe damage is often associated with that, and I had the sutures in my forehead fused when I was born, so I sometimes suspect that it might be involved. Given an option, I would go to quite a long way to have this fixed. I'd happily have brain surgery, but would rather not have anything done to my nuts. Unfortunately, I think for most that this is an orientation and that kind of thing can't really be fixed. I feel that it would be best if support and accountability and for some supervision was offered.
So you're arrested. Is there any kind of medical or psychological support for you? Don't know where you're from, but in my country there are such kind of therapies to control your illness and not become a perpetrator.
After being arrested, I was assessed by a nurse, essentially to confirm that I wasn't about to kill myself, and was given the number of a charity which I could call. I have not done this yet due to anxiety issues and the fact that I've been burying my head in the sand for a while. Interestingly, it is an organization I had reached out to before and found their help to be unhelpful. We talked briefly via email and I suspect that they didn't consider me to be that much of a risk, so communication just stopped.
I've always felt deep sympathy towards people like yourself. I'm curious, what legislation can be done to help people like you? I know this is a controversial idea, but would it help if you were able to get prescription child pornography? It would still be illegal to make and distribute, and the videos, confiscated from offenders, would have to be altered in a way that protects the identity of the children. Or how about prescription CGI child pornography? Seems like a victimless crime. The goal would be to increase the quality of life of pedophiles, and also to provide them an outlet so they don't act on their impulses. Of course, this would have to be studied to make sure it has the intended effect, but if it is proven to work, I'd be for it. Not that it really matters because this kind of legislation would never pass.
That's an interesting point, and the idea of a safe outlet for these feelings is something that has had some negative consequences. I initially started my interest looking at anime-style images depicting childlike characters, and this led me down a slippery slope towards seeking more real and graphic images. This is because by feeding an obsessive behavior you increase the obsession. A Japanese pedophile has set up a company selling silicone childlike sex dolls which he claims will help people avoid acting out. But you've got to be pretty obsessed already to spend $6,000 on a sex doll. And I suspect that some would be spurred on by this. I have heard people claim that existing child pornography should be treated like ivory, that exchanging existing material would be okay but creating new material would not. This really misses out on the impact on the child, and whilst the child doesn't know who's looking at their abuse image, they are still hurt by this. In terms of a solution, I feel like it should be treated like any other mental health condition and destigmatized. It's nobody's fault that they are this way, and help and support should not be something you fear. Arrest should lead to treatment, not punishment, in cases where no direct harm to a child has occurred.
Thank you for posting. I have a few questions. First off, have you ever been diagnosed with any other mental illnesses? Before you were arrested, did you ever talk to a counselor about your feelings? If you didn't, were you just too afraid of the backlash? If you did, what was the response?
I have been diagnosed with dyspraxia, which I feel is somewhat unrelated, and depression, which was partly caused by my condition. I have had counseling for depression, but I manipulated the conversation so that this wouldn't come up, because I feared being labeled and arrested, as I had enough evidence on my laptop to get me arrested, so I just kept it to myself. I have contacted the only suitable charity in the country, but they seemed to only be properly interested when a child was at risk. The sum total of our conversation was a few emails with me describing my situation at length, and a volunteer who sounded out of his depth replying without giving any helpful advice. The conversation then dried up.
Has this been something that has affected you your entire life? Have you had romantic relationships with adults, and if so, how has it affected those relationships? Have you ever told a close friend or family member? If so, what was their reaction?
Pretty much. I've been facing this since my teen years, and I think it has severely negatively impacted my relationships with people my own age. I have associated sex with a sense of shame and wrongness, so I have been incredibly anxious about asking girls out. The first girl I asked out was so when I was 22 and I then essentially ran away. The second I asked out by Facebook Messenger as I feared rejection. The third a friend asked on my behalf, and the fourth I asked using the company's email. That being said, I had a date with someone last week and we are meeting again, so there is hope. I'm close to 30, by the way.
Do you have a fear that one day you will act on your impulses?
No. I know myself and have enough restraint. It's like being married. Whilst you are attracted to others, you know it would be wrong to cheat, so you don't do it.
Do you think pedophiles can be cured, like, let's say, people with mental illness? Have you ever spoken to a therapist?
I'm not sure if it's formally recognized as a mental illness or a sexual dysfunction. But it is a mental condition that causes harm, so I feel that it is a valid description. No one chooses to be a pedophile. I am not exclusive in my views, some are, so I do find girls my own age to be appealing. I generally prefer people who would be cute rather than the sort who would be considered sexy. I haven't seen a therapist about this issue, as it would have cost me my job, as this issue cannot be kept anonymous to them. Also, the police advise against this. I have contacted a charity about this, but because I was not seen to be putting a child at risk, they didn't really help. Also, I strongly suspect that curing pedophilia would be as likely as curing homosexuality. What should happen is that people should be given the cognitive tools and accountability to avoid offending.
Do both male and female pedophiles distribute child porn?
Nope. Only ever guys. I know that women do get arrested for having sex with minors, but as a general rule, everyone seeking child porn is a man, and almost everyone who makes it is a man or are driven to by a man.
As a rape survivor from 6 to 9 years old, I want to thank you for coming out. I have heard only 2 to 5% of sexual abusers of children admit their wrongdoing. It takes a lot of courage. We know that conversation therapy does not work to make people ex-gay. What type of treatment do you think would support people like you lead a healthier, less harming others' life? Also, have you told your family? How have they reacted? Do you engage in or avoid drinking or drugs to attempt control over this? Have you been attracted to adults? How has dating been? I really wish the best for you.
Wow, that's awful. I don't really have the words to express how bad that must have been for you. Well done on surviving, though. I am surprised by that statistic, but it makes sense in some ways, since anyone knowing how harmful it is wouldn't do it. I know how wrong it is, so I know that I would never do it, and I expect that the many non-abusing pedophiles like myself wouldn't, as it's crossing such a hard moral line. My family do know, as when I was arrested their place was raided too. Honestly, I've lied to them about this, claiming that I never really intended to access that material when I did. I know though that my mother would still love me, but be really disappointed if she knew. Finally, my moral line is so strong that I can trust myself with alcohol and pot. Not that I use them too frequently, but I find that the cannabis helps me deal with my anxiety.
You said you would never act on your desires. So what do you think makes a person go from viewing child pornography to actually assaulting a child?
I think for some who suffer from pedophilia and other cognitive distortions that child porn normalizes abuse to them and numbs them from feeling empathy for the child. I feel most who do it don't understand how bad it is. Additionally, there are a number of dark net groups where people are encouraged to make and share abuse images.
Is the dark net traceable? If you get convicted, would you consider ratting out those groups for a lesser sentence or no sentence?
As far as I'm aware, it's not traceable, but a number of traps have been set up, including one page which the FBI took control of and kept running for a couple of weeks to gain people's details. I am expecting a supervision sentence myself, so that is about as minimum as it gets, but I'd be happy to rat out anyone who has harmed a child and give directions to relevant sites, as I hate the whole child abuse industry and wish that child porn had never existed.
You said you never harmed a child, but isn't viewing child pornography harmful to children? By viewing it, you are the contributing to the demand for it. I consider that very harmful to the future children who will be used for pornography, because of people like yourself who view it. Furthermore, you said that you're attracted to women your age. Do you intend on having children in the future?
I'm not going to lie, you are right. That being said, the person who makes it has no idea how many have received it, so the feedback they receive is very limited. So in some ways I don't feel that this cycle is influenced by lurkers who only receive it third hand. Not that I'm trying to justify it at all.
What are some signs of pedophilia a parent can see in their child? Signs of pedophilia a wife can see in her husband? If someone in my family turned out to be a pedophile, what should I do? Do you talk to your family about it?
Tough question that. I'm sure it's relatively normal for teens to access images of people close to their age, so the actually accessing of material is not a clear indicator. I was extremely successful at hiding it, and I always cleaned up the laptop afterwards so anyone using the computer would never know. Also, I suspect that teenagers these days would mostly consume porn on their phones. As a parent, occasionally checking their history is worthwhile, and expressing that porn is normal is too. It should be taught to children what child porn is and why it is wrong. If someone close to you is a pedophile, then just treat them as before you knew that. If they are outed or arrested, life will be really difficult for them, and many people who get arrested are minimal risk to society. A pedophile is a human being often fighting an ongoing internal battle.
All you did was view a photo on the internet? How did they know it was your intention versus a misclick? Or genuinely didn't know the girl was so young? Should I be worried about teen sites and college girl sites? Are these even normal-looking sites, or is it very clear where you're and what you are doing?
As far as the police were aware, at the time they arrested me, was that I had uploaded an image of a girl who appeared to be 12 to a photo analysis site, and I don't remember the image, but it was probably fairly clear. They interviewed me under the innocent until proven guilty approach, so I gave across my story and they listened and were accepting of the story I gave. I'd suspect most legitimate teen porn sites are fine, but I'd avoid anything that is presented with the term jailbait. Stick to Reddit for porn, it's usually fine.
What were you arrested for? Regardless, you are scum. It is only a matter of time before you ruin some kid's life. I hope they lock you away forever. There is no cure, no excuse, and no redemption.
I'm sorry you feel that way, but I understand your position. I want to apologize for my actions and would like to clarify that I have never harmed a child, and I think that doing so is deplorable. I believe that pedophilia is a mental health condition, and that just because someone has it does not mean they lack the restraint that would lead to them harming a child. What people need is treatment, since pedophiles are people who never chose to be how they are, and many have spent their whole lives desperately trying to not act on their urges, and most with those urges do not go on to harm a child.
You have harmed children. Get this into your thick denial-laden head. You participated in forums, sites, and who knows what, catering to this evil. By the mere fact of doing so, you helped create a market for it, which perpetuates it. You looked at photos of kids who were being abused. You shared photos of kids being abused, even if you didn't share photos of kids in the act of actual sex. Just taking photos of underage kids in an abusive or manipulated situation is abuse. You are deluding yourself if you think that your actions have never harmed a child.
I never shared photos. I only downloaded them. Also, I never participated in the forums where the new images were shared, so the people who made them never knew I looked. That being said, I still know it's wrong and hate myself for it. The one I uploaded was to an online tool that was used to analyze if it has been doctored in any way. This was not a distribution service.
I was wondering if there are any documented conditions of women suffering from pedophilia? Is this more of a male thing?
It's definitely less common, but it does happen. I suspect either the incidence of females being pedophiles appears lower as they do not get arrested for child porn offenses, as women tend to get less into porn. I've never seen a female pedophile on the internet.
I find your description of it as an orientation interesting, so you do not believe it is something that could be cured? You've offered some insight into the programs you think would benefit those who suffer from this illness. Could you expand a little on what you think those programs could and should look like? If you had the opportunity, would you consider donating your brain to science upon your death to further research in the area of what causes these impulses? You've mentioned you also find women of your own age attractive. Do you find yourself attracted to women who still pose as a young look? And is this something you would eventually address with a long-term partner?
I definitely think that pedophilia and the other words that fit under the umbrella term are either paraphilias or orientations that the sufferer has no control over. That being said, I would still call it a dysfunction or disorder, as it is not an acceptable sexual preference to express. What I would like to see is the option for anonymous non-disclosure therapy to be available either online or in person. This would be done using cognitive behavioral therapy to teach techniques to suppress unacceptable urges and distract the sufferer towards acceptable things. The public perception of pedophiles as monsters is damaging, as for most it's just not true. I suspect that most people suffering from this brave a moral compass which allow most people to not abuse. They are also often people who suffer from depression from carrying this disorder as a dark secret that they can never discuss. Also, I do have a preference for young and cute looking adults instead of the traditional large-breasted type of woman that is usually seen as sexy.
Can you understand why I, as a parent, even though you have never hurt a child, would want to hurt you if I found out you had been around my child? People are comparing it to other mental diseases and whatnot, but considering how innocent and defenseless children are, it's a totally different ballgame and is why it's such a stigma. I know it's not right, but could you understand the way people like me behave with the issue?
Yeah, I do understand that, and to someone like you, I would emphasize that one of my deepest held moral guidelines is to never harm a child. That being said, I can totally understand your concerns and how disastrous it would be if you placed your trust in someone like me and they abuse that trust.
I don't really have a question, I just want to say my dad is a child molester. He never hurt me. But I did see him hurt someone else for years secretly, and as a little kid I would intervene. He will never admit what he did when he eventually got caught. Even as a 6-year-old I knew what he was doing was wrong. It's a hard thing to have to know that half your genetic makeup can do something so messed up. I spent years hoping I wouldn't be feared by my mom's friends around their kids if they knew what he did, just because it's in my blood. I don't really have any kind of relationship with my dad. As an adult, I now understand that he isn't right in the head, but I can never forgive him for what he did.
Wow, that sucks. My grandfather molested my mother, so I guess I know where I got it from, but I really hate that man. He was such a hypocritical bastard. I have almost no sympathy for people who knowingly abuse children. I know some people don't understand the harm that they are doing, but still it makes me really angry. I actually sometimes research the images that I saw in the hope that the abuser got jailed.
Do you think that pedophiles such as yourself would willingly come into the open and be receptive to mental treatment like a drug user if the government created programs for you to help you? Or do you think even if such programs were available, you'd still want to shield yourself from societal judgment?
Yeah, I feel that coming out is not something that many people would be willing to do. That being said, the option of anonymous support would greatly benefit both them and society.
I've lived a life where I was exploited for the creation of child porn. From the time I was 12, I was photographed and videotaped with a fear of death and blackmail until I was 24. You may have personally seen images, audio or video of me masturbating when I was 12. I'm angry and frustrated that you seem okay with seeing it. I don't want any person to look at them. I don't want you to masturbate to a picture of me while thinking of having sex with me. Please don't look at child pornography. It hurts that when I interact with a stranger I wonder if they've seen me. That when video or pictures are taken by friends I worry. Trauma is insidious. It's like a virus I always have. Don't look at pictures. See a therapist. Until you do those two things, I will give you no sympathy. You were arrested for seeing a picture of me or others like me. I don't care. You deserve to be punished for exploiting us or benefiting from our exploitation.
I am truly, truly sorry for what you have been through, and I don't think that there is anything to say to make it better. Looking at that kind of thing is not okay. I acknowledge that, and I have no intention to view them again. I'm really sorry for what happened, and I think that there are ways to stop what happened to you happening to others, and I believe that allowing people to anonymously be treated would help both victims and perpetrators who both have their lives ruined. I've been dealing with depression since I was 16, so I have suffered to more than most courts could administer.
Have you ever considered killing yourself? It would be a reasonable solution.
Yeah, I have, but I've come to the conclusion that I am a net positive to the world and it would do a lot of harm for me to give up now. I have a lot to give to society. I have a high-level degree and have a good job that benefits society. Being dead wouldn't protect any children and would cause great harm to all the people I know.